amazing product. Plug and plague. The terrible ColecoVision.
I can't keep it up. Hi, welcome to the stream. I have a plug and plague for you today. It's a little different than usual, considering this was an actual system. And I forgot I even had this. It's the ColecoVision flashback. And this is gonna shit on some people's... I don't know. Childhoods, I want to say. It's a kind of a one of those things that you just you hear about, but you never play it if you're above the if you're below the age of 30. But yeah, this is the ColecoVision flashback. I've had this since Too Many Games last year. Someone just bought it at the convention and gave it to me, and you know, here it is. And I'll tell you all about it in a second. But before I do, and before I shit on the ColecoVision and its games, take a look at this. So that was Limmy. And this is the ColecoVision flashback. ColecoVision was a game system, if you want to call it that, that came out before I was born. And let's learn a little bit about it before I begin. 1982. So I remember my cousin, who was 9 years older than me, talk about the ColecoVision, and he didn't have one. He knew people that did, and I was like, ColecoVision, that sounds so cool. What is it? And he was like, it plays games. I'm like, yeah, but Nintendo plays games, and it's better. But, you know, that wasn't a problem, because it only sold like 2 million units. Was discontinued in 1985. So by the time I was young... Well, by the time I was young, wow, that's a statement. By the time I was like 3 or 4, the ColecoVision kind of just faded out of memory. But this was like one of those plug-and-play kind of things where they tried to revive it, and it's bundled with a fuckload of games. Those are the controllers, those things with the numbers. There's like buttons on the side that you can press. And no, that's not a wheel. It's actually an analog stick. I think it was a wheel originally. But I think they may have remastered some of the controls for these games. You hold it vertically, and it is weird. Like, you pinch the buttons, and you use the thumb on the thing, on the stick. And the numbers, I don't really know what that's all about. But some of these games might be good. Really? I don't know. I haven't played them. I never played these games. So, we're going to find out if ColecoVision Flashback is Plug or Plague. Alphabet Zoo, I guess we'll play. Spin Naked presents Alphabet Zoo. Whoa, no thanks. No thanks. Okay, all right. I'm ready. Penguin. There's a penguin. How do I begin? I'm ready to begin. Okay, so you become... Do I get to choose my player? No. Wow, this is a menu. Letters. I'd like to choose the letters XYZ, please. Oh my god, do you see these options? That's amazing. I'm gonna go for a mix. I like a healthy in-between, you know? I like to solve the puzzle. It's water. Oh. Five? What do I have to do? I have to collect a five? Or maybe an S? Because it looks like a five? Five. What the fuck? Wait, maybe get these things. Like Pac-Man? Like Pac-Man. Do I get to, like, gobble up the letters now? It's that I got the thing? All right, now this is five. Everyone say it with me. Five. Wow. I got an F. Oh, I have to spell five. Like, with letters. F. Well, I got the F and the other one. Wait, do I have to get another F? Watch it teleport away before I get there. F. Where's the I? But where's the I? Let me get a G. No. Alright, well, I guess you just have to get a bunch of fives, or Fs. F, five? Five. Oh wait, lowercase f. I don't know if I won! I have pressed button. Alright, now I think this is a dog. It's gonna be a dog. Look at these graphics. Oh man, the ColecoVision. So whenever you complain about video games, just remember. You were at least born after this stuff. But when this first came out, remember, this was amazing. People lost their shit that you could interact with your TV set. Come on. D. I guess I just have to collect D's? Do I have to collect D's? You collect D's. That's what you do. You just keep collecting that first letter. You don't have to spell it. I don't think there's any way to win. You just let the time run out and you let your disappointment wash over you. And you feel at one, as one, with the ColecoVision. But first, the disappointment. There's people disappointed I'm not playing Zelda. As if 12 hours in 2 days wasn't enough. Trust me, you'll get it. And you're gonna get it good. But not tonight. Everyone and their grandmother, pulling the car around, is playing Zelda. This is your not Zelda stream for a little while. Just this one time. Just this one time. Not that I didn't play Zelda today a little bit. I didn't do anything of substance, but I did find some Koroks. Just saying. Have your grandma pull the car around. Let me guess, dice? Wow. The vitriol of me saying the word Zelda has enticed people to say fuck Zelda. Bappy garbage game. No. You're the Bappy garbage game. But hey, look, this is a preview of the Switch's indie game collection, alright? This is about all it can handle. So let's not shit on the Switch too much, because look at these graphics. Whew. Look how fast I'm going. We'll do one more picture. I also like that there's people trying to convince me, or others, that the Switch and the Zelda are the worst thing ever conceived on this planet in a chat of thousands of people that's going that quickly. Like, if you're gonna take that much time to write a comment, write it on a video, you know what I mean, where no one reads. At least do that. Let me play my baby games, okay? Fox. Collect the Fs. How about we collect the restart button? And we'll check out some other games, because that one is infuriating. Aqua Attack. But the A is the end of the word aqua. Holy shit. Look at these graphics and those colors. Oh my god! Well, we're right into the thick of it. So I'm James Bond, and the world is not enough. I gotta lower this garbage. Oh my god, my ears. My ears are fucking bleeding. And we just started. How do you restart? What button do I have to press? The 5 button, perhaps? I'm pressing every button. What has happened? Oh, okay. It just takes a while to load. So the you move up and down. Oh, you can shoot. Oh my god. You would not believe how I have to play this. This is atrocious. So the two things I have to pinch on the side shoot up and down, and then I have to press like the 5 button to shoot straight ahead. This is unbelievable. You need 3 hands. You need 3 hands to play this. Holy fuck. Oh wait, you can shoot, like... Hang on, how do you even... I'm not sure what I'm doing here. There's like the gun is just shooting wherever it wants. Seriously, at this point, I don't even know how to control this goddamn thing. So we're just gonna reset, because I'm getting a little aggravated. Back in my day, when the game was the game. Artillery duel. Now remember, again, if you were like 10, 15 years old in 1982, this is what you had. And you spent like $60 on these games. That music is definitely copyrighted. Skill level. Yeah, I'm a corporal, sorry. I guess this is a 2-player game only. That's officially the worst version of that song I've ever heard. Okay, so you get to choose the barrel. Oh boy. Okay, so we've all seen games like this. It's kind of like Worms a little bit, right? But look how fucking slow this goes. I have a pad with numbers. I don't know if you guys know that, but my joypad, it has numbers. It has numbers. I can't input the degrees. How much powder do we need? Well, we need as much powder as we can get. Well, that's it. Hope you enjoyed it. I don't have the second controller plugged in. Bankruptcy Builder. Oh, you mean like the ColecoVision itself? Land. Okay, land doesn't work. Land. Coasts. I don't know what I just did. I'm pressing buttons, but nothing's happening. Oh god. I don't know what's happening. I don't know what's happening. I'm so confused. I'm sending out artillery from the previous game to various locations across the street. Or we're a fast food chain sending out, like, strawberry smoothies. I'm not really sure how this is... Hey kids, do you like statistics? You should get Bankruptcy Builder! There was probably an overlay to help with this. Yeah, I mean, this system had overlays and instructions and stuff, but this does not count. There is none of that. Blackjack Poker. Now, you can't fuck up Blackjack Poker. 1983 Coleco. This has got to be good. Or at least, it's got to be a game that I can understand. Enter your pot. $30,000. Oh shit, we have what looks like a person. I can't believe it. Oh. Oh, there's music. Can we not do the music thing? I can't bet zero. I guess that's a sound effect of cards shuffling. It kind of sounds like I'm getting hosed. Hit? Yeah, give me another hit, man. Give me another hit. What button is hit? I guess I need the overlay for that. Yeah, hit me again. Oh, no. I've busted. Not like that. Did you see his face? When I lose, it looks like he gets busted on in the left eye. At 49. These stakes. The stakes are real. Insurance? You lose insurance. Oh, come on. What does that even mean? Hit. Fuck! This is the best use of the number pad that I've discovered yet with the ColecoVision. Let's keep going. Something tells me I'm still gonna lose. Hit. Fuck. This is a poker dealer from Westworld. Vaguely, you know, he's vaguely Western. Vaguely cowboy. No, don't hit. Nope. I will stay. You have 21. Oh, you cut! Cheater! You fucking cheater! Fucking robot. Well, I mean, no. This is a bust, isn't it? No, don't hit. Can I math properly? Oh, because it's one. Ace can be one. I forgot. I haven't played poker in a while. I won with 14. Expert poker player. Remember when I said, who doesn't know how to play poker? Me. Hi. No more hits. No more hits. I'm gonna need to hit a fucking mescaline after this, but not, you know. No hit. You lose. He's only happy when he loses. Maybe I misjudged the dealer. Maybe the dealer isn't your mustache twirly villain. Alright, that's poker. Well, best game so far. Blockade Runner. This one has to be great. Space Junk? Huh. Are these boogers? I think they're supposed to be asteroids, but asteroids are brown, right? Not booger colored. Also, this music or these sound effects kind of reminds me of going to the dentist. Anyone else getting dentist vibes from this game? Yeah. Game. Yeah. Back in my day, the game was the game. Brain Stainers. That's a good name for a game, I'm not gonna lie. From Carousel Software. I wonder what they've been up to lately. What games are they publishing these days? I wonder if any of these developers from like the old Wild West of video games, the Atari and ColecoVision days, are actually still in the industry. I know some of them are, but I wonder how many. I mean, they're definitely, like, they were in their 30s, 40s when they made these games, right? So, oh, it's Simon. I mean, Brain Stainers. Consider my brain stained. Bump and Jump. From Data East USA. Wait, didn't Data East actually create other things? Or am I thinking of... am I thinking of the shovelware on the Wii? Expansion module? No, I'm good on that. Ah yes, the joys of racing. Where ladybugs and pickles can race together. In peace and harmony. I'm thinking of Data Design Interactive. Yes, that's correct. Oh, fuck. Crashed into a bone. I mean, it was nice of these road builders to, place bones. Wow, cool game. Wait a minute, was that the end of the track? I don't understand. Was that intentional? There doesn't seem to be a way to speed up. What the fuck? There's no jump button. There is no jump button. Oh, it's called Bump and Jump. Okay, you have to press the button a few times in a row to jump. Swear to God, the first time you press the button, you do not jump. Pressing it, listen. Watch this. You hear that? Amazing. Listen. That's the jump button. Now it's just not jumping at all. Okay, oh no! It jumps when it wants to! Even though it says jump okay, still pressing. It only works about 50% of the time, I've learned. Okay, now I got it down to a science. I got it down to a science, everyone. Alright, no, okay, alright, so... even though it says jump okay... That doesn't mean pressing the button automatically makes you jump. You have to hold the button down. Either that or the controller is just as broken as the left Joy-Con. I'm gonna make it. I am gonna jump over this chasm. Oh, that's good. That's good. That's good games. Let's see if it works this time. I'm gonna try to go forward. Nope! Not enough time! Not enough time! Uh-oh! Here we go. Yeah! Yeah, I fucking did it! How'd they do it? They didn't even jump. Cheaters. Yeah, if you just hold it down, you tend to jump. Alright. Well, I figured out the controls. Time to move on. Chop lifter. Broder Buns chopper lifter. Sorry, chop lifter. Dan Gorlin. One guy made this game. Okay, now this has some level of quality. Wow, Dan Gorlin actually made a good game. Yeah, this isn't terrible. Well, you know what? No. I think I have a little bit of Stockholm Syndrome. If this was the first game I started with, I probably would have made fun of it pretty badly. But the fact that... Oh, they're all dead! Oh man, this is an event that will be remembered for centuries. So as I was saying, compared to the other stuff, this is okay. On its own, this isn't a game I would play. But it's kind of fast. The controls make sense. You can shoot. That's a bonus. And yeah. It's a video game. Shocking, I know. Someone said, Choplifter's, a pretty enduring series. What, so there's been more games in this series? Probably because this one didn't completely suck. Let it envelop you. I don't know how capable of good sound design ColecoVision is, but that was pretty annoying. Universal's Cosmic Avenger. Alright. Universal's Cosmic Avenger. Wait, Universal Studios? Do they have their own superhero? That might be the future. That's where those things look weird. Yeah, it's the future. Oh no, it's not a superhero, it's one of these games. It's Shitty Galaga. It's kind of crazy how some of these ColecoVision games are nearly indistinguishable from the plug-and-play games I've played. Like, stuff that was developed 10 years ago, 5 years ago. It's like, hey, check out these cool retro games! 501! And then you play ColecoVision, and it's like, oh no, these were the games that people played and enjoyed 35 years ago? Almost? That's a spotlight, I guess. Kind of represents the spotlight, maybe. I mean, when you have such limited hardware... you kind of have to. You have to do weird, abstract things in an attempt to make them look like something. Like that? Green pumpkin. Green pumpkin has been killed. Oh, the Switch is looking at least a little bit better than I thought it would. Haha, move on, next game! Crown Jewels 2. And I say that as someone who actually likes the Switch. Press fire to continue. That's not helping. I don't know the fire button. Just press every button and find out which one is the fire button. 2007. Wait, what the hell do you mean, 2007? Oh shit, it's Luftrausers. So I guess they got a dude to make some new ColecoVision games for this collection. Wasn't I just talking about, like, plug-and-play games that came out within the past 10 years that were as interesting as these games? I guess they're still making ColecoVision games, or they were. Hey, you know, it would be cool if you could, make a sequel to that game you did 30 years ago. Homebrew for these old systems is still pretty alive, really. So I wonder if this is actually homebrew, or if they got, like, an original developer to make a game. Oh shit, 2013! Wait a minute, what does this have to do with the previous game I played? This isn't an airplane shoot game. Oh boy. Oh, the amount of fun I'm having. I can't contain it. I'm just having too much fun. Is there such a thing? Am I gonna need, like, detox after this? So much fun. You died. Wow. Well, we're just going through these games, huh? Destructor. This is back to old ColecoVision. You know, back in the good old days of 1984. A world without Vine Sauce. A better world. Oh, that's good music! Nice dissonant music you got there. So... okay. This is like a precursor to Zelda. The original Zelda, but without all the good things. You kill the bugs, you get crystals from them, I think. And then you can beat the bugs with their own fallen friend corpses. I'm pretty sure that's what's happening. Some really, really good sound effects in this game. Just in case you forgot you were in a vehicle. Enjoy a loud rumbling noise the entire time you play this.
Nah, man, we don't want you to forget, you know what I mean?
Okay, I understand. So you're actually competing with an opposing tank thing. You just have to crash into the things and then drown them in the blood bagel. You munching me? Oh, I'm dead now.
Get ready for disappointment!
Dragonfire. Keep in mind, this sound is bad. The real ColecoVision sounds much better. Really? Like, how much better? Are we talking, like, 50% better? Is it still beep boops? Oh, wow, I can actually tell what's happening. Like, it's a castle and there's a dragon in there. Holy crap. Oh. I think I'm the dude. Yeah, I think I'm that little fella. Amazing. You have like a 1 millisecond window. And even then, and this is level 1. What the hell's going on here? I think that's player 2. Also, no wonder it looks so good. It's only one screen. You've got to jump the chasm. That's what you've got to do. Hello, hello, traveler. Welcome to Adventure Call. I'll be your guide into this journey. I'm gonna do it! I did it once. I can probably do it again. There we go. Okay. Ah! Fucking scrotum. Scrotum dragon. Skark! Did I lose? Yeah, I lost. What is this dude hoping to accomplish in the dragon's den? Thou art finished. Thou art fuck yourself. I think you have to climb. So like, you get to the rampart, you climb it, and you fight the woodsman? The archer? I don't really know. Oh, come on! Ah! I don't think I care anymore. Evolution is next! More good music. I can listen to this all day. Alright, so I'm a little fella. I'm a little spermatozoa. In a world of DNA and amoebas, right? And I have to... collect. This is like indistinguishable from some of Limmy's video games that he fakely created for his video. Yeah, it's time to evolve. Evolve, please. Oh man, amoeba into frog. That's how that works. Now, what you don't realize is that this is a very early version of Frog Fractions. Super early. But don't worry, the space segment's coming up. This was developed by the current president of Xbox. Who said that? Really? Are you serious? I believe it. Ex-president, he went to Facebook. Wait, Don Matrick? Was that the dude who was involved with the fiasco and he had the face? Don Matprick. It says Don Mat- oh, look at that, I wasn't reading the name before, but yeah, it actually does say Don Matrick. Same guy? Fatholm. Sorry, that's what it says. Fatham? What the fuck is it? What is this game? Oh, Fathom. Oh my god. I'd like to apologize. I couldn't read it. The font was too small. Like, what the fuck? I was trying to figure out what kind of game this was. I was like, wait a minute. How does this have anything to do with video games? Alright, well, no, what you're doing is you're collecting, well, you're eating seahorses and avoiding jellyfish, because we all know that dolphins do not eat jellyfish. Okay. That's great. That's a great game. Oh, fuck. Oh, wait, no. Oh, this is straight up Echo the Dolphin. Oh, when you lose your points, you die. So Fathom. Fathoms. Oh, like fathoms under the ocean. How many fathoms? I was like, not sure if it was that definition of the word, or like, I can't fathom that a dolphin would not eat a jellyfish if it was really hungry. I think this is a dolphin. Also, this game kind of blows. Oh shit, the octopus! Give me that. Give me the one. Oh no. Oh fuck, the octopus. It brought me back into its cave. It's having its way with my dolphin. I don't like this. Actually, I just don't like the game. Flipper Slipper. Speaking of dolphins. Spectra Video presents Flipper Slipper. Already dead. Amazing. It's like Breakout. But each time you lose, you have to go through an unnecessary- What the fuck? Well, this is a really weird version of Breakout. Oh my lord. The rules are entirely different. It has its own set of rules. And there's just a turtle in the sky. Do I collect the turtle? I don't know if I'm supposed to avoid the turtle because it's an innocent bystander. Wait, is it spelling something? Mioi? Oh, game over. All right. Break all that shit. Yeah, I think I have to kill the pig, though. The turtle seems like an innocent bystander. The pig seems to be, like, the evil mastermind behind all this. And the UFO, well, that's just a UFO. Oh, and here's the sound of what appears to be waves.
definitely not ColecoVision static. It's waves. It's the ocean. Listen. It's immersive. You're in the ocean. Oh no, you get points if you kill the turtle. I wonder if some kid played this game in the early 80s and then went out and started killing turtles looking for points. Oh, it's the ham. Guys, the villain of this game is the fat ham. So that's what that was all about. I cannot fathom a joke like that. This one's, what is this now? Fortune Builder? You can build your own fortune by circuits and systems. Huh. Jen. Oh, slow it down. This is the second time they've taken a song, like an old standard, and applied it to ColecoVision. Oh no, it's gonna loop the entire time, isn't it? It's kind of SimCity-ish. I'm sure someone figured out how to play this. Someone figured this out in the 80s. The one person that bought this game. I don't know why it does that. It just looks from left to right. What's that? You want to build a thing? Nah, fuck you. Fuck you. Here's a view of your left and right. Okay. No more Vivaldi. Frantic Freddy. The prequel to Freddy Got Fingered and Five Nights at Freddy's. It's a weird series. Loosely connected. But it's all the same Freddy, trust me. Speaking of Freddy, the year this game was made, Queen was like the biggest band in the world. So...
Yeah, I'm Freddy. Yeah, look at my stupid fucking face. Yeah, look at the googly eyes. Yeah, put out the fire. Ooh.
You are Freddy. You are a bug. You must dodge the red orbs of destruction. Put out the fire with your bug spit. And, I don't know. Then go... get fingered, and then open up your very own pizza place. This is the pizza place. Wait, is Freddy a hot dog? I'm really trying to figure out what Freddy is. Invincible fire. Cool. Good shit. A monkey holding a pizza box. It just kind of looks like a sausage or a hot dog to me. I mean, if you see a monkey holding a pizza box, that's great. I'm proud of you. I see a hot dog, like a dancing hot dog fella. This one is called Frenzy. Stern's Frenzy. Howard Stern was... first starting out in the 80s. That's some cool dissonant music you got there, too. They cut to black because you don't want to know the unspeakable things that are happening. Oh, he's getting hosed. Jousted. It's terrible. Oh my god. This is the worst, like, game over death scene ever in a video game. What happened to this poor guy? Oh, okay. And we're back. What the fuck is this shit? What is this? Oh my god, electrocuted! I think these are skeletons. But maybe they're aliens? Wow, way to give me a minute to, like, gain my bearings. You just immediately start, and there's a bunch of squids trying to, like, get their tentacles in you. Great. I'm not into that kind of shit. Oh, robot attack! It's just a smiley face. That's not a robot, that's... it's an emoji. This game was emojis before emojis. Oh, cool. So you can't shoot unless you're moving. It's a feature. Really though, I can't just stand still and shoot. I have to point in a direction and move. It's fantastic. Freddy got fantastic. Oh, that was Frenzy. Sorry, not Freddy. Gateway to Apshai. Not hopeful this is gonna be good. Characteristics, you say? Dagger, leather armor. Select a dungeon. One. Okay, so this is actually like a kind of a, almost a roguelike, I guess, maybe? There's no stab animation. I mean, there's a stabby sound. Man, Breath of the Wild, the graphics in this game, fantastic. You are carrying short sword. Can I use short sword? How do I destroy this rat? How do I kill the rat? Slain by a rat. A lowly rat, fella. You are carrying short sword. I am ready to use the short sword. Oh, there we go. You have to select the fight option. Lead coffer. Golden scepter. Sceptre. Locate trap. Check supplies. Next level. Push to confirm. Yeah, you just go to the next level, I guess. I mean, it's kind of impressive for ColecoVision. Am I having fun? No. But I mean, that's not the point. The point in these video games wasn't that they were fun, necessarily. It's like, look, you can move a picture on your TV set. Now, obviously, I'm sure people had fun with these games. I'm sure if you really got into it. You know? If you really got into it. You could have a good time. Check weapons. Oh, the fucking controls are terrible. Move on. Gust Buster? Clown music! I love it!
Hey, boys and girls! Select the
balloon. Oh, look, we got a tutorial. Select balloon by pressing 1, 3, 7, or 9. Pump right fire button to inflate. That's the first time. That's the first time a video game has told me to pump a button. Yeah, pump the button. Oh, whoops. Mistakes were made. So you move by inflate. How do you inflate? Here we go. Oh, fuck. Oh, no, I'm dead. Dead clown. Oh, it's actually like a baby. It's a baby with a bunch of balloons. I see. Good. Oh! It was a 1, 3, 7, or 9, right? To choose the balloon. So let's do 3. Pressing 9. 3. 1. I don't... Does that... What am I supposed to do? Oh no, I'm dead. Are those supposed to be people or aliens? Those little white things there, those are aliens? What is that? Game over. Well, it's definitely an interesting concept. It's kind of a puzzle game. Wasn't the worst game I've played. By the way, gotta reset. Oh, whoops. I accidentally turned the system off. It's better this way. Gunt Bunter. Alright, this is Jumpman Jr. One players. One speed. Oh. I don't know why that's funny. I think I chose a very fast speed. It's too fast. It's just too fast. And I'm dead. Whoop. Oh my fucking god, I don't know what the hell this is. This is the prequel to Mario Brothers, by the way. Mario was originally called Jumpman. This was when Mario was just a bab. Nothing to it! I wonder if this was like... a Jape Donkey Kong. Like, maybe Donkey Kong came out in the arcades, and they were trying to like popularize on the success, and they were like, Jumpman's not copyrighted. Let's just call our game Jumpman Jr. Oh. That'll make money. I liked it better. This is a super popular Commodore 64 title, really. I think I liked it better when it was the fastest speed in the universe. This is just boring now. Fuck. Instead of dodging barrels, Jumpman Jr. Oh my god, he just got shot through the legs. Right up into the butt. By a white orb. Which, if you know, ghost hunters, when they see a white orb, that is when the orgasm is released. Because that's sure proof of a ghost. Jungle Hunt. From Atari? Huh. A Oh, good, good. Good job, Atari. This is a good choice of menu color. I am a fan of lime green and yellow text. That's good. I don't like to be able to read the things on the menu. Early Donkey Kong. Broken legs. Gotta be patient. It's the same cycle every time. There's no speed runs of this game. But there will be. After this stream. It's all the same cycle, so you can just memorize the position of all of these things. What the fuck? Wow. Well, first of all, diving has transitioned me out of my clothes. Fucking red alligators, sons of bitches. Leave it to Atari to make one of the better games on the ColecoVision. That's probably in the top three games I've played today. Mecha 8. And again, perspective, too. I jape and I jest about these games and how terrible they are. Some of them are legitimately terrible, but then again, NES had some legitimately terrible games on it. This is a 2013 game. Holy fuck. Okay, now this might be homebrew. This is Mecha Research's lab. Invaders took our armies and well, whatever. December 2078. You can tell it's the future because the music makes you want to kill yourself. That's always a good sign of future music. Horrendous noises that infect your brainstem.
I'm hurting, Stimpy, please! Turn it off! Turn it off!
Trisha Thunder here. I'm ready to fight. And again, killer squids. It's excellent. I don't know what it is with these ColecoVision games and, like, squids being a really, nasty enemy. Well, I guess squids are easy to draw in tiny pixelated form. Everyone knows what a squid looks like. Kids, however, are a little bit harder to draw. Definitely. Well, it's a shooter, and it's not the worst thing I've ever played. The number buttons don't do anything. That's okay. I mean, it's made in 2013, so it's just someone's passion project, I would imagine. I'm surprised they could get the ColecoVision to look this good. This almost looks like an NES game. Almost. But yeah, I mean, it's functional, and it's video games. So I'm gonna go ahead and take Mecha 8, a game that was created in 2013, and say that this is the best game in this ColecoVision collection thus far. So, Miner 2049er, sorry. Miner 2049er. Okay. Live Say Computer Games made this one. Game concept by Bill Hoag. Yep. All right, now. Well, my name is Bill Hoag. I'm about to make a video game. It's called something about fun. Micro fun. The fun goes on forever. Mm-hmm. Prepare to enter level one. I mean, you're not going to be able to stop having fun. Because we took what y'all know to be this Donkey Kong thing, and we made it even better. That's right. Well, first you got to jump over the squids. And then, kind of like Pac-Man, you got to cover all the ground. That's right, Bill Hoag. That's my name, Bill Hoag. Wow. This really is just Donkey Kong and Pac-Man put together. You star as an anthropomorphic lemon. Yep, those are the Pac-Man power-ups right there. And you just ram into the enemies. I don't know why I'm so fast. I guess it's because I'm the Senate. Huh. This isn't terrible. This is pretty okay. Sure, it's combined. Wow. That's a fucking brutal death. Sure, it's combining two really popular games into one. Not bad, though. Not bad. It did it in a way that didn't make me feel angry. So, not bad. It's my review of that. Module Man. Original game by Ryan Olson, 2013. No shit. ColecoVision version by Mystery Man, 2013. Begin! We will begin. Oh, I know this song. What is this song? I don't understand what's happening. I'm Mario. Green sleeves. It's a Christmas song. All right. So I'm Mario with a gun. Go in the door. Oh, I have to get the key. Or I could just die. Oh, I have an energy bar. Uncharacteristic for ColecoVision games. One fuck up and you're dead, mostly. But yeah, I'm getting like medieval vibes. However, I have a gun. I can't actually get that, can I?
Nice of the princess to join us for dinner, eh, Luigi?
Nah, I'm just kidding. You can't get the key. Alright. Oh, man. To think I could be playing Zelda right now. I don't get it. Oh, okay. I had to go into the blue one. And only the blue one. You have to press up. Another turtle. I'm noticing a theme. Lots of turtles. Lots of squids. Now the key picks up. The other one didn't. This one does. I'm not sure if, like, again, the theme of this game is it Christmas? Is it Christmas? Is it fucking, is it medieval? Is it gun? Is it Super Mario? It's all over the fucking place. Monster Masher. Monster Masher. 2006. So many of these games were not made when the ColecoVision was actually a thing. Which leads me to believe that the people who put together ColecoCore, or whoever the fuck made this plug and play, was like, there's really not enough good games in the ColecoVision. We need to do something. We need to pad out the collection with more games. Yeah, just fucking throw those homebrew shits on there, whatever. Just whatever. Some massive music. Massive. I think I'm dead. I don't know what's happening. I don't know where my character is. I'm genuinely confused. And you know what? I'm bewildered. I'm now just bewildered. Above all else. The music just can't get the fucking tune right. Just keeps skipping. That's, shocking. Montezuma's Revenge. The Parker Brothers. I didn't know Kevin Parker had a brother. Good. Your neck is broken. Try again. Asshole. What was that one game on the NES? Spelunker? You know what I mean? This is basically that. This reminds me of that. Oh, cool. Got some nice fall damage. You're telling me this dude, someone who is willingly taking up a life of exploration... All right, maybe I'm thinking a little bit too deeply about this. But he's actively taking up a life of exploration and, you know, cave diving and going into dangerous situations. He can't, like, fall 10 feet without dying. Come on. Game over. That's an arbitrary game over if I've ever seen one. What's the point of lives in a game over if it just starts you in the exact same spot? With the exact items that you've already collected. Oh, this is fucking terrible. These controls are really bad. Really touchy. I think I got a legit game over now. Oh, no, the screen is just frozen. The screen is just frozen. So there was real game over. There was fake game over and real game over. Moonsweeper. The prequel to Minesweeper. From... Imagic! That was hyperspace, I think. It just looks like TV static. But, oh man. Okay, here we go. We got a shooter that's attempting a 3D perspective. Ah yes, the ocean! Just beyond the rings of Saturn! Everyone knows of the ocean. around Saturn. It's okay, it's- I'm on a moon. I'm on a moon of Saturn that has an ocean. The fuck are these things? Oh. Okay. That kind of plays like a Robot Chicken sketch. You get a little bit of static, and then you just... And then... Star Trek. Let's make fun of Star Trek. Picard. I don't know, that's Family Guy. I don't know why I'm doing Family Guy. Ah, yes, the ocean of piss. So, yeah, you have to fly through the, now... There's, like, little dudes. Are these people? You have to collect the people, and then you can fly back... into hyperspace? Oh my god. Oh man. I'm so happy... that I was born in 1985, and not, like, 1965 or 75. 'Cause... this would have been my video game entertainment. I probably would have loved it regardless, because I mean, you know, that's what you had, that's what you had. Motocross Racer from Zonox! Okay. Oh, doodah-day. I love these developer names from the 80s, too. Zonox! Imagic! It's like, it's so cool. This doesn't make any fucking sense. I'd rather play Desert Bus than this. If you go too fast- okay, what is this now? Oh, what is this shit? If you go too fast, your engine, like, burns up. What the fuck is this? Oh wait, I think you just have to switch gears, maybe? Motocross Racer, let's try that again. Dude, I'm working on the railroad. Watch! As you go the thrilling speed of 50! Oh, I'm sorry, 25 miles per hour! Wow, what a thrill! Switching gears, it does not make sense. I'm pressing the switch gear button. Can't switch. Can't switch. Here we go. I got something. I figured it out. Figured it out. And... never mind. One. No, now I press two. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. I guess you have to be over a certain amount of thing. Of speed. And then when you get to third gear, it's just like, eat a dick. Nah, you can't go fast. Fuck that. Annoying. Mountain King. I can already see the music in my head. I know what it's gonna be. Yep. The Hall of the Mountain King. Is that a flashlight? What is that? So am I in a mountain right now, or... like, getting to the mountain? This is like the thing that Samus has in Super Metroid, it reveals secrets. Except there's no secrets, there's just ladders. I guess. This is the best game to glitch. How do you glitch it? If you mess with the switches, the game would glitch. I don't think I can do that. What switches? What do you mean? Oh, good. Shelob just fucking wrapped me up. I'm trying to- I would like to glitch the game. Oh, AVGN covered this? It will take too long to glitch. There are two ways to glitch it. Glitch heaven and glitch hell. I think you need the original console to glitch this game. I'm not gonna bother, I don't really care that much. From, why am I saying from? It's like I'm looking at art. Oh. Oof. Good title screen. Miss Space Fury. Look at them aliens. Handsome. Please no. I don't know what's going on. I'm the alien. Wait a minute. I thought I was the little dude. I'm not the little dude. I'm the alien. Wait, is that little dude really like a threat? Yeah. The little dude kills me. This game. Again, another weird Pac-Man clone. Kind of. Well, not really Pac-Man, but it's just collect the things. It's kind of like that Donkey Kong Pac-Man hybrid from before, but worse. Hey, check this out. Yeah. Expert pro tip, dudes. If you hold the jump button on the ladder, you can fly all the way to the top. So far, the music on ColecoVision has been a fucking home run each time. Nova Blast. Here's the glitching. Alright, let's see. Mountain King. Yeah, you need the original. And it's just glitches. When I say glitches, or it's just glitches, I mean the screen gets a bunch of pixels on it, and it looks like not very much different from the game itself. If you told me that was, like, par for the course from that game, I would believe you. I'm a cadet. I don't think I can play this game on hard. I don't think I can play this game. How do you start? Oh. You have to press the star button. What's a defender clone? A very vaguely disguised defender clone. Or thinly disguised, I should say. Thinly veiled defender clone is what this game should be called. It's a load of fucking shit. That was my AVGN impression. Any good? I don't think I've ever had this much fun playing ColecoVision. Ever. My favorite part of this game is holding the button and going right while simultaneously going up and down. Fuck, the sense of freedom is just... it's transcendental. Wow. So I guess you gotta protect the cities. That's the twist. It's Defender, but you have to defend the cities and stuff. Move on. Next game. Oil's Well. Oil's Well that ends well. Whoa! America Simulator. I get the concept. I understand it. I don't like it. What are these, like, bugs doing in the pipeline anyway? Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Are these... These aren't cars, and these... This isn't a road, is it? Oil acquired. The prequel to this was that war game I played. Which one? All of them. Omega Race. Bally Midway. I wonder if that has any relation to Midway from later on. Oh, there's game modes. Fast Bounce it is. I feel like I'm stepping into a world. A world I don't necessarily need to be in. Me and Steampy patrolling space on a little bit of space madness. Oh, my beloved ice cream bar! It's asteroids. Just a little different. It's a little different asteroids. $60 games. Pepper 2. The sequel to Sergeant Pepper. Pepper 2. Speaking of Ren and Stimpy. Some of that stock Ren and Stimpy music. Wait, is this just Oil's Well? This is kind of... Oh, I get it. Let me capture a trident. Trident captured. Fuck yeah. Now this is an interesting take on Pac-Man. I like how most of what I've played has been just like Pac-Man hyphenated with another thing. But yeah, you just have to kind of- it's like Jez Ball a little bit, but more Pac-Man-y than Jez Ball. It's Pac-Man hyphen Jez Ball. So... yeah. I probably would have liked this if this was the type of video games I had to enjoy. This one probably would have been something I would have enjoyed, because I liked both Pac-Man and Jez Ball when I was younger. So... I wasn't always this jaded. You know, there were times where I could enjoy a nice simple game. For a little while, I was addicted to Asteroids. There was like a free version of Asteroids you could download on your computer. And this was before a lot of, like, free games were available. Where you could just, oh, go on a website, here's 1,000 free fucking games. It's like, there were shitty Flash games. And then there was Asteroids that I found. And I really enjoyed it. So, yeah, I could enjoy, like, simple concepts. I don't need, or I didn't need, the things to be, like, these massive... extreme cases of... gameplay and innovation. Whatever the fuck I'm talking about, I don't know. I'm sure someone will figure it out. Go right. Yeah. So that's probably on the list of decent games. Controls are a little wonky because of this fucking weird controller, but otherwise it's not bad. Princess Quest. Princess Quest. It's a princess named Quest. Living in a tribe called Quest. I'm sorry. The legend says that a beautiful... wait a minute. This is Clockwork Orange music. There I was, with my Drookies. And that's the Karova Milk Bar. Wow. She was made prisoner. Those ghosts look like they're humping the buildings. That is a hump animation if I've ever seen one. Sorry, this is where all the budget went. The game will be dots from here on out. It's just gonna be dots. It's a 2012 game, of course. Original game concept, do not steal. Super ghosts and ghouls. But why would someone go about remaking Ghosts and Goblins? You know, on a system like this, like, it sucks. The controller sucks, the game sucks. Why would they, well, I mean, the original was great, but... it's just so much more limited now. And maybe to put it on a resume? Or just for funsies? I don't know. Those are my solutions to this problem. To this conundrum. Desert music. It doesn't mean that it was made in 2012, it just means that it was put out in 2012. Fair enough, but I do think that this was a later ColecoVision game. This doesn't strike me as something that would have been on the system originally. Oh fuck, a treasure chest? Guess who's never getting that? Not me. Oh fuck. I saw a shiny treasure chest, I got excited. Quintana Poo? Oh. Quintana Roo. Okay. So this is where you go to pray to Ra. Oh, this is actually probably, wrong kind of temple. Sorry. Wrong god. This is where you go to pray to Quetzalcoatl. Someone said walk up the stairs. Oh, how nice that would be. How nice and simple and amazing that would be if I could just walk up the stairs. Or, well, the steps. Oh. Sorry, Quetzalcoatl. How do you say it? I don't really know.
Quetzalcoatl.
This is where the reptilians landed back when they were using us to mine gold for them. And, you know, this is where we worshiped the reptilians as gods, where they preyed upon us and, you know, grew strong from our blood sacrifices. It was a long journey for them, but they ultimately got what they needed, then left. No, I'm kidding, they didn't leave. Touch snake timer appears. Oh, I'm poisoned now, I think. Well, at least fucking something happened. Quetzalcoatl is pleased. Climb the sides. Oh, yeah, what do you know? Oh. I was just pressing every button. I was holding every button. Because these buttons are kind of wonky. These controllers, I don't know if you know this, but these controllers aren't the most well-made. They're mostly hollow, cheap pieces of plastic. These, not the original Coleco controllers, but these remakes for the plug-and-play, you know? So, you have to kind of hold the buttons and press them multiple times. So, I just pressed all... How many buttons are there? Like, 14 buttons? Oh, this fucking sucks. You would think it would be easy, right? And just go up the stairs, right? Wrong. You get stuck. What's that? You want to avoid snakes? Well, fuck you. Something has happened. And now the game is completely different. I'm here. Hello. Yes, I'm here to rob your tomb. Oh wait, no, I'm here to die. Sorry, I meant die. Roll Overture. I knew it. I knew it was gonna be Beethoven. Roll over, Beethoven! These fucking developers have a hard-on for classical. Bop. Platformer, but you have to collect music. Oh my god. Yeah, you have to, like, change the switches so that the music is filtered into the proper location. In this case, E. There's no flats and sharps. Well, played the wrong song. Game over. Oh, and you can die! Wow, what a horseshit concept for a game that is. It's like a puzzle game, platformer, music game thing. I can imagine the developers, like, the concept is like, alright, we need a new game for the system. What are we gonna do? What are we gonna do this time? Well, alright, I say we take Donkey Kong, and we combine it with Beethoven, right? Oh, and then, we add a little bit of, Pac-Man for good measure. Oh, it's brilliant. Okay, well, what's next? Alright. Puzzle game. But with a little bit of Pac-Man. Brilliant! Publish! Okay, what's next? Well, we take a game when you're in a spaceship. But this time, it's a little bit of Defender. But, it also has Missile Command. Brilliant! Start with Pac-Man. And then just go from there, you know? Sammy Lightfoot. That That was the... It just didn't finish, but it was that. Is this a trampoline? Yeah. I am a trapeze artist. I'm now dead. That's a circus. That's what that is. I was wondering if that was a temple of some sort. No, it's a circus. That is a circus tent. And I... I'm a master. I use the trapeze with the greatest of ease and get myself killed on a bowling ball. Please. Oh no, that's a pumpkin. I'm sorry. Everyone knows. Oh wait, the pumpkin is at the top. That is an egg. A perfectly rotund egg. May I interest you in a nice egg during these trying times? Going to be sick! Schlange. Well, I have a new name for my dick. Excellent. Thank you, game. Thank you, ColecoVision. You've given me a greater gift than you could ever imagine. Wow. So it's called Schlange, and there's just like a bunch of, you know, schlong-shaped snakes. It's almost too obvious.
Hey, you know, step right up. Come on and get yourself a Schlange.
The previous name was Frank Reynolds. That was decided upon last night. I was actually watching Always Sunny. I managed to catch up. The cricket episode was fucking incredible. The gang runs a bar. Amazing. Frank grew a tapeworm and named it Jerry. And Charlie was getting jealous of the attention that Frank was giving to Jerry the tapeworm. I don't know. I think I'm the green. So I'm the green snake, right? You know what's cool about being the green snake? I have no control over my character. I actually don't think I'm playing this right now. Seriously, I don't think I'm actually playing this game. I'm not. I'm not actually playing this. I think that was just computers. Oh, I immediately died. That's what that is. Okay. Oh, no. I was red. I was the red snake. And my Schlange. My Schlange, died immediately. I understand what happened now. Okay. I get it. I'm now officially in the know. I know how to Schlange. Okay, now I can't start the game. Good. Fucking great. Good game. Okay, then. Search for jewels. Fire button to start level. This is also not an early ColecoVision game. I think it said 2003. So I'm the balloon. Land on the platform to win the level. So it's kind of like that lander game, the lunar lander, except, you know, you're a balloon and you have to avoid bullets. And then it turns into this. Sweet Jesus. Is this the galley? Is this the deck of a pirate ship? I don't know what's happening anymore. I thought it was cowboys and Indians. cool movement speed, by the way. Shunting puzzle. Let me use my schlange inside your schlunt, if you don't mind. Oh, I hate it. I hate it so much. I already fucked it up. I don't care. Sorry, shunting, not schlunting. Sir Lancelot. Yeah. Yeah, music. Oh yeah, it's heroic. Wait a minute, is that a dog? No, that's a horse. What was that game with the ostrich? To joust? Huh. Kinda jousty. Kinda very jousty. It's like joust, but a little different. You have to like kinda joust into the dragons. Huh. Well, it's not the worst game I've played. It's a little balloon fight kind of controls. Okay, never mind. No, it's terrible. I don't know what counts as a dragon kill. Slurpee. Okay. That looks like corruptions. Alright, so I'm Slurpee. And I... I have to... I guess I have to just suck the things... into my nose tentacle. My snout. And then I become the thing. And then I turn the game off. Back when the game was the game. Sega's Space Fury. ColecoVision presents Sega's Space Fury. Sega? No shit. Huh.
Whoa! Sell a creature for my amusement. Prepare for a battle!
Look at those lips. Look at that face. Cabbage. Yeah, nice original game you got there, Sega. Never have I ever seen this concept. Oh, there's upgrades. So it's a little different. It's like Asteroids, but with aliens. And different, like, upgrade dock units. I've been vaporized. Warrior One, get ready! Go! No! Space panic. Universal's Space Panic. ColecoVision likes to present games. You know, Sega was off making Asteroid clones before they came up with the totally original Sonic concept, which was just Mario but fast. Even Sega did it. I'm joking, Sonic fans. I'm joking. So this is a game That's a little bit like Donkey Kong. Alright, except strawberries. Well, there is something original here, which is, it's like Donkey Kong, but Minecraft. So I think you have to dig the strawberries into a ditch, and then build over them, and then they die. So, almost a little, what other game does this remind me of? I don't want to say Dig Dug. Anything else? Was there a similar concept? Oh shit, the strawberry killed me. Great. Squish'em Sam. It's the second Sam we've discovered tonight during the ColecoVision segment of our stream. Load Runner. There you go. Load Runner. I've never actually played Load Runner, or if I have, I've played like a cheap clone of it. Okay. So this is another original concept. You're climbing pipes. Right? You gotta climb the pipes. And avoid the rabbits. Definitely not Wrecking Crew. Or Wreck-It Ralph. No, that's not good. Squish'em Sam, Wreck-It Ralph. Supercross Force. We're almost done, don't worry. And I have a special surprise after this Plug and Plague segment. Special surprise. Kind of looks like Vader's TIE Fighter, doesn't it? Back in my day, the golden age of game. Pew, that's a pew game. You pew, and you don't die. Telly Turtle. Yet again, more turtles. ColecoVision's mascot could have been a turtle. Is this a drawing game? It's like Color a Dinosaur, but 10 times worse. Oh god, save me! Oh, could you imagine trying to draw an actual picture like this? Could you fucking imagine? Good button. Good fucking buttons. My hard work ruined. Let's see how long it takes me. Like, how much of this can I draw before I get banned on Twitch? Still good? Let me just steal that classic Craig Ferguson bit. Yeah. It's okay, Craig wasn't using it anymore. So you... Whoops. Sorry, Telly. And is this bannable yet? Are we still, we're still in good territory? Whoa, it's a little lopsided. A little not so great. Just kidding, it's a middle finger. Fuck you, Teleturdy! Whatever. Teletubby. The Dam Buster. Michael Bate. Steve Armstrong. Mary Lou O'Rourke. Steve Armstrong. Dan Hoek. Hoek! Oh yeah, I know someone else. I know another Hoek. Oh, it's Ren's brother. Oh, God. Please stop attempting 3D. Please do not do 3D things on a system like this. Just don't do it. Just don't do it, man. Please. Are there enemies? Are these dots my enemies? Jesus fucking Christ, this is extensive. There's a lot of depth to this game. It's just a shame it's such garbage. That was anticlimactic. No Damn Sky. The Heist. Micro fun. You have a little bit of fun. Not too much, just a little bit. You wouldn't want to hurt yourself now. Remember, kids, it's more fun to go outside than to play video games in the 80s. Is that Luigi? Luigi's wearing a pink hat. Hey! Hey! Yeah, this is my first official appearance here in ColecoVision. Whoa! Look at those graphics, Mario! Man. How long did it take platformers to get good? When did developers realize, like, stop making them slow as shit? Was it Super Mario Brothers? Did it really take until then? Okay. I just went, like, into a coffee. Nice escalator. Don't go in the coffee.
Don't wheeze on the electric fence!
Threshold. Donkey Kong, 1981. Even Donkey Kong was very stiff. It was a basic platformer. You know, I mean, it worked, but, like, you couldn't change the direction of Mario, and Mario went pretty slow in Donkey Kong. Granted, Donkey Kong was a huge step up. And it was definitely, like, a leap forward many degrees. But it took, I think, until Super Mario Brothers on the NES to really, like, get the platformer controls and the speed of a platformer to make it, like, really viscerally fun and not just a slow, like, slog through AIDSville. Another space shoot game. Am I alive still? I don't even know if I'm alive in life. Because, like, I've just lost track. All these games are blending into each other. I'm gonna forget all about this stream by the time I'm done with it. Like, a week from now, someone's gonna be like, Vin, I liked your ColecoVision stream. I'm gonna be like, what are you talking about? I don't remember. I don't even know what a ColecoVision is. What are you talking about?
Space squids!
Tomark the Barbarian. Tomark Marin the Barbarian. This Zonox company is really overloading the system. Me Tonark. Me walk. Let me cower and hide. That's a feature of this game. You can teleport. You can also, like, cower in the corner. See that mouse? You can be afraid of it. Only in Tomark the Barbarian. Yeah. Look at that. Look at that jump. Yeah. Wow. I hate everything. What? Why is the mouse doing this? I could be playing Zelda right now. This is like the Flea Man's jumping pattern from Castlevania. Let me guess, a mouse is going to appear on the screen any second now. Shocker. And then there's this. You press down, you look at this. That's what happens when you press down. Anytime you press down. That. What is that? Why is that? Well, I'm gonna need some serious treatment after that one. Tournament tennis. It can't be bad. It's tennis. How do you fuck tennis up? Sorry, the pixels have to load. Is that a sperm? Oh no, tennis racket. Yeah, that's me. I'm without a name. This is how you fuck tennis up. No, actually, it's tennis. It's fine. That's my review of this game. It's fine. It feels like almost like tennis a little bit, like video games. Feels like video games is my review. Fine and feels like video games. 3 out of 10. Oh, by the way, you just hold the button down. You don't have to worry about swinging at the right time. Just hold the button down. Still very slow. Very slow. Venture. Load. This screen represents how I feel throughout most of the stream. Alright, so I am literally... Don't you like saying literally like that? Isn't that just terrible? I am a red dot, aka smiley face man. I'm in batshit crazy land, collecting radish. Write a fucking original song, for Christ's sake. Uh-oh, alien encounter. Remember that video game crash? That nearly, like, killed the industry?
Yeah.
ColecoVision was made right around then. I didn't say anything specific. I didn't say ColecoVision contributed. And that these wretched, god-awful creations had anything to do with the consumer fatigue that was the video game crash. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that it happened around these years. And if you put words in my mouth and think I said anything different, well then shame on you. Is that a tractor? Is that a nuclear power plant? Is that a duck? I guess I have to defend the United States from these unknown star assailants? I don't know. Florida, known for its tractors, its nuclear energy, and its duck. Fresno. It's actually got- oh look, they're just cities. Hey, check this one out. See this one? You should take note of that one, in particular. Kansas City. Oh fuck, Minneapolis wiped off the map. New York City, still going. It's a tractor. It's known for its tractors. This is just watch cities get destroyed, the game. Oh, I'm out of ammo. Well. US cannot be saved. Wing War. Almost done. I've never been so happy. It's almost over. So remember that Joust game, that Joust-esque game that I played earlier? Well, this is very similar to that, except now I'm the dragon. And again, balloon fight-esque controls. I'm not sure where the wars are, it's just like shit falling from the ceiling. Which may or may not be spiders. And stalactites, which I think are the ones that hang from the ceilings. I always get those confused. Stalagmites, stalactites. I ran out of fire. A dragon with no more fire. It's not even a dragon, just a turkey at that point. Well, there's actually some variety of things to look at. I mean, and the game doesn't control like complete shit. If the fire was infinite, I probably would enjoy this a little bit, you know, if I was in 1982. I'm sure there's some objective of some sort. Stalactites are the ones that hang from the ceilings. Stalagmites are the ones that grow from the ground. Cool. Bap. Bap. I need that. I don't know what that is, but I need it. Oh, gone. That's cool. I was one pixel away from it. Now, you know what? I take that back. These controls are not good. They're not really... They're not particularly precise for a game where you have to pick up pixels. You know, it just takes you so long to even turn around. Like, I think I have to pick this up. I don't fucking know. Hello? What do I do with this? Oh, I know how to do it. And finally, Zaxxon. Sega's Zaxxon. Okay, so let's see what Sega was up to before Sonic, yet again. What hybrid of arcade games will this be? It's a bit Galaga. little 1942, which I don't think came out yet. I'm not sure it was in the arcades in this category. The problem with adding elevation to a game like this is you don't know exactly where you're shooting. You can't tell. You don't have a sense of depth. It's not terrible. It's not the worst game in this collection by any means. It's just like, why? Why are you doing this? This is just Zaxxon, really? So this was its own thing then. And this was an actual, like, thing that people liked in the arcade. Fair enough. Hey, I wouldn't take it away from you. I'm here to be, like I said early when I first started this, I'm here to shit on people's childhoods and memories. And I'm sorry, but, you know. It's just stuff that is just not good and has not aged well. Some of it was okay. There were some decent games. This is not the worst game. I'll tell you what's terrible about this now. You gotta guess! Where are you shooting? I don't know! Go up and down until something hits! Oh wait, no, you can just hit them from wherever you are. That's fine. Well...
Gregor Boy 95. Gregor Boy, there's a sniper under the chopper.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that's the ColecoVision flashback. And there's actually people that grew up with that game, that Zaxxon game, and apparently the shadow is the way you tell depth there. But that's fine. No. The shadow was cool. You could tell where your ship was. It's just the shots. It seemed like the depth thing was a little ahead of its time, and maybe not in the good way. But I didn't play it as a kid, so I don't know. Really, all I can say is I never really played any of these games as a kid. So the nostalgia factor isn't there. For me, video games began at NES because I was born 1985. And all these old games, there's definitely ones that stand out. Like I said, Asteroids, Donkey Kong, Pac-Man, those are the ones I loved. Then there was a few others here and there. I went through my arcade phases when I was growing up. So yeah, there's definitely good arcade games. There's definitely good stuff from the early 80s, late 70s. But then I got spoiled because I was growing up playing Super Mario Bros. 2, Zelda, Contra. I was playing shit like Mega Man. I was playing stuff like Castlevania. So it kind of makes these games hard to appreciate. That said, I hope you had fun watching me make fun of these games and generally just be terrible at them. I had a lot of fun, but my God, I'm so happy it's over. That was ColecoVision. And much like any system, it has its good games, it has its bad games. However, if this was the best that Coleco had to offer and put them all together into one neat little package for plug-and-play gameplay, then I would say the bad stuff, the stuff that was not enjoyable in the slightest, most certainly outweighed all the good stuff. You can send your hate mail to me now. I know if you're above the age of like 35 and you want to strangle me, I'll tell you what. Meet me at PAX. I'll give you a free kazoo. If you're disappointed, you get a free kazoo and a pin. We'll call it even. Sound good? Why don't we take a quick break? And we'll begin the surprise game I have for you. And, yeah. And then after that, shitty Luigi games. So, stick around. Be right back.